Dale McConachie, and I'm a senior here at Carnegie Mellon in Electrical and Computer Engineering. I've been working on developing motions for snake robots to bypass obstacles. One thing we're really good at with snake robots already is cyclical or gait-like motions. So for you and I, that's something like walking or running, and for a snake robot, that's something like sidewinding or slithering. So if you've ever seen a snake move, we can reproduce those sorts of motions fairly well. What we're not particularly good at the moment is a discrete movement. So for you and I, that getting out of bed, getting into a car, reaching for a glass of water, that's something that we're not very good at on snakes yet. What I've been trying to do is develop a method to create trajectories that will allow us to do these discrete movements. One thing that happens in nature already that is pretty cool is that when you get out into your car or get into somebody else's car, you do pretty much the same movement already. You just make little adjustments. So if we can actually develop a technique to get motor skills like those on a snake, we can then start to make our snake a lot more autonomous out in the field. What I've done is taken something that's called the dynamic movement primitive, which has that ability to scale built into it, and adapted it for use on snake robots. So what these DMPs do is they give us a way to describe your trajectory that you want to follow based entirely on a few parameters. So instead of having to describe the entire trajectory, you can just describe it with a finite number of points, in my case, 40. When I implemented this, what we found is that the snake robot was reliably able to get past a rectangular beam 72% of the time, which is pretty good, but it's not our goal. If you think of some of the applications that we use snake robots for, like search and rescue, you don't really want to have a 72% success rate when trying to move past obstacles. You're looking for something much higher, 95, 99 if you can manage it. So what we've done is we've taken those parameters and applied machine learning to them to try and adjust the parameters a little bit to try and get a more robust motion. What we found when we did that is that snake robots are incredibly difficult to manage. And it's not exactly a trivial task to try and find the perfect parameters. One thing that we can try and do is to reduce the mountain-like nature of the problem, if you will, to something that's more of a rolling hills instead. If we can do that, if we can reduce the number of parameters that I'm trying to work with, then we're going to have much greater success applying these gradient descent machine learning techniques. There's a lot more research that needs to be done here, but what we did find is that we've got a relatively robust motion that is a good basis to start from, and we'll see what I can come up with over the next year and a half or so.